The Sea of Thieves beta came and went, and it seemed like a lot of people really enjoyed their time with it. But for some people who didn't get their hands on it, and probably some who did get to play it, there may be some unanswered questions still about what exactly is going on in the world of Sea of Thieves. Today on Game Ranks, here are 10 things you need to know about Sea of Thieves. Starting off at number 10, I've seen some confusion on how exactly Sea of Thieves multiplayer works. Well, it's a shared world, so there will be other players running around doing the same exact things that you're doing. So while you're on an island hunting for treasure with your crew, another player-controlled crew could show up, kill you, take your treasure for themselves, and that's it, you're just dead. Or you could come across another crew while sailing, and you could murder them, sink their ship, then swim down to their wreck and collect all of their treasure. There actually aren't any NPC-controlled crews running around at all. Every ship you see out in the distance is a player-controlled ship that you could either ignore, or you could go right for it if, you know, you're that kind of pirate. Now, obviously, not every Sea of Thieves player is spawned into the same world. Worlds will only have a certain number of players that are allowed in them. Also, when you do spawn into the game, it's gonna make sure that you spawn somewhere safe, somewhere where you won't spawn in and get murdered right away, so you have a minute to kind of figure out what you're doing and where you're going. Moving on to number 9, probably one of the coolest things about Sea of Thieves is that it's crossplay. So if you're playing on PC, you can play with your friends that are playing on Xbox One and vice versa. I think this is such a great feature, especially with this game being so centered around actually playing with other people and working as a team. It's also an Xbox Play Anywhere title, so if you buy it digitally on either PC or Xbox One, you actually get it on both platforms. A few months back, design lead Ted Timmons said that players on PC were 4.5% more efficient at killing skeletons than console players, and that PvP balancing between the two platforms was something they were focusing on. And that was back in August of 2017, he said that. So hopefully this close to release, they figured that out. Next up at number 8, as a pirate out on the open seas, obviously you have your typical pirate tools. You have a sword, a pistol, a blunderbuss, a mug for grog, typical run-of-the-mill pirate stuff. There's also different resources out in the world that you can collect as well. There are also barrels of gunpowder that, if used right, could actually be used to combat enemy skeletons or even enemy players. Throwing a barrel of gunpowder into the path of a ship that's chasing you could cause some serious damage to that ship if it runs over that barrel. And then there are maps, which are used very cool because they're actually things that you like hold and can show other players. And the same goes for the world map on the ship. Like when you're down there using it, other players can see what you're doing with that map and just spectate, and you can really kind of, you know, tell them what you're looking at because they can see it too. But the best item by far is definitely your bucket, because not only can you use the bucket to get water that your ship has taken on and throw it overboard, but because you can also throw up in that bucket and then throw that throw up at other players and blind them, which is definitely a dickhead pirate thing to do, and you know that's awesome. There's no denying the awesomeness behind throwing a bucket of vomit at someone else's face. Coming in at number 7, as expected from a Microsoft published game, obviously it's going to take advantage of the extra power of the Xbox One X. It's going to be running at a native 4K according to Rare. In an interview, they pointed out that it doesn't use any checkerboarding or upscaling tricks, and that it's native 4K and will run very close to what you'd get on a beefy PC. It's also going to have HDR support, and if you've played the beta or the alpha or have just seen any footage, you already know that the colors in this game really stand out and pop as it is, and HDR is only going to make something like that so much better. Next up at number 6, while we did mention PvP balancing really quick, it's important to note that Sea of Thieves doesn't really have a leveling system, at least not in the traditional sense. Progression isn't based on how powerful you are, because whether you have the starting pistol and sword or ones that you got after dumping 40 hours into the game, they're always going to output the same amount of damage. Rare did this to make sure that there's always a level playing field. Everyone is always the same and has a fair shot. Although if you've been playing longer, I'm sure you'll have a better understanding on how the weapons control, so that might be where you get a one-up on other players. But in terms of like weapon stats and stuff like that, they don't exist. Next, number 5, Sea of Thieves is definitely something that's best experienced with friends. Seriously, like, everything about this game is better with friends. Traveling back to your ship after finding a treasure chest? Well, you're gonna want someone to watch your back and fight the skeletons you can't outrun. Sailing is also a lot more fun when you have a full crew, because you get to have someone in charge of each aspect of the sailing. One person steering, one person as a lookout, one person navigating, one person on sails. There's a ton of stuff to do. And communication is key here as well. It's all about teamwork. Splitting up on an island, for example, there's no mini-map, and you can't see your crew's name or an outline of them through a wall or through a giant rock. So when they're out of sight, they're out of sight. You actually have to communicate to find each other. Like, hey, I'm near this big rock. Are you near this big rock? Having a full crew also makes fighting other crews in the open seas a lot easier too. I mean, you can fire someone out of a cannon onto or near the enemy ship and have them board that ship and either kill everyone or just steal their treasure and dip. It's all teamwork based. Everything is based on teamwork and communication. And communication is key here, and that's how you're gonna be the best pirate that you can be. But really quick at number 4, while Sea of Thieves is better played with friends, you can still get along fine by playing by yourself. For one, there is matchmaking, so you can make new friends to play Sea of Thieves with if you do want to play with a crew but you don't have any friends of your own. But you can also play by yourself with a one-man ship. The ship has everything you need to sail, everything's in closer proximity to you, so everything's easier to reach. So while on the larger ship, where the anchor is on the opposite side from where you're steering, with the smaller boat, the anchor is actually right behind you. So all you have to do is spin around and boom, you have an anchor. So don't worry, if you're a lone wolf, you'll still be able to play this game and still enjoy the time that you spend with it. Coming in at number 3, what you're doing mostly throughout Sea of Thieves is completing voyages, which is what they call quests. Voyages will be collected from and completed for 3 different trading companies in the world. The more you do, the higher your reputation gets for those 3 companies, and then you can start taking on harder and more rewarding voyages. There are the gold hoarders, and they'll offer up voyages that are straight up treasure hunts, where you'll be solving riddles, finding the X that marks the spot, stuff like that. The Merchants Alliance, which will give you trade requests, which will require you to collect a certain amount of resources and hand them in before the contract expires. Those resources could range from anything like gunpowder or a bunch of chickens and pigs. Then there's the Order of Souls, who hand out bounties for undead pirates. These voyages are more combat focused, seeing that you'll be fighting hordes of skeletons. Besides working for these 3 trading companies, you can also just set out and try to find treasure by searching islands or searching shipwrecks. You don't necessarily need to be attached to a voyage to do it. Next at number 2, so while Sea of Thieves is in this big open world where you can do whatever you want, it's actually lacking a story. There aren't any story quests, and you aren't working towards some greater goal. It really is quite literally an open sandbox where you can do whatever the hell you want to do. Don't want to go on quests and just want to be an asshole pirate and steal everyone else's treasure? Yeah, you can do that. You can spend 40 hours doing that. Or if you want to be a good pirate and not raid anyone, you can do that too. It's really all up to you. Whatever you want to do, that's exactly what you can do. There is some lore, it seems though, like you'll see cave paintings of a kraken on different islands, and there is a faction that focuses on the magic in the world of Sea of Thieves, so I'm sure there will be some explaining there. But for the most part, really, you just get to do whatever you want, with no story attached. And finally, at number 1, so without a story and not being able to get more powerful weapons and lacking a traditional leveling system, what exactly are you working towards here? What shows that I'm a better pirate than you? Well, a lot of it is just cosmetics and bragging rights. As you complete quests, you'll earn gold, and that gold is used to purchase cosmetic items, and it will also up your reputation with certain companies and give you better voyages. And there are a ton of different items to purchase. It's not just clothing and new weapons, but also pirate accessories. Yeah, pirate accessories like a peg leg or a hook, a cool beard, or even tattoos. So a new player will be able to measure your skill based off of how cool you look. The same goes for your ship. As you progress and become more rich, you can also afford new sails, better cannons, or even a cool figurehead. Basically, like I said, you're playing for a bragging right, which is measured by how cool you look, how cool your ship looks, and the type of voyages that you can go on. And those are 10 things you need to know about Sea of Thieves. We want to hear from you, so meet us down in the comments and discuss all of your upcoming pirate antics down there below. And as I'm sure you already know, hitting the like button really helps us out. And if you're new here, subscribing may be a good idea, because we put out videos like this every single day. As always, thank you for watching. We really appreciate it. And we'll see you next time, right here on GameRanks.